Hello friends, my name is Mohammad Suhail and today I am going to start new subject from BPharm third semester, that is Pharmaceutical Engineering. From this subject I am going to start unit 2, that is heat transfer. In this session we are going to learn definition of heat transfer, objectives, application and heat transfer mechanism. But before start today's session, it's my request to you. If you people have not subscribed my YouTube channel yet, please do subscribe and hit the bell icon so you never miss any update from my YouTube channel. So without any further delay, let's start our today's session. So first of all, what is the basic definition behind heat transfer? So basically, heat transfer is the process of transferring heat from an object of high temperature to an object of lower temperature. Now, all matter is composed of molecules and atoms. These atoms is always in different type of movement, that is translation, rotation and vibration. And the movement of atom and molecule produce heat or thermal energy. In the thermodynamic system, heat transfer is the movement of heat across the boundary of the system due to temperature difference between the system and surrounding. There are three modes of heat transfer, that is conduction, convection and radiation. First we'll see conduction. So conduction is the process of transfer of heat between two substances that are in physical contact without mixing. Then second mechanism of heat transfer is convection. So it is the process of transfer of thermal energy from hot place to the cold place by mixing of warmer portion with cooler portion of same material. Then third, radiation. So it is the process of transmission of heat through the empty space by electromagnetic radiation. Now moving towards to the next topic, that is application of heat transfer. Heat is required for weight mass during production of tablet. During distillation, heat is required to convert liquid into vapor. Then in case of steam distillation, steam is required which is in direct contact with material. For crystallization of drug, supersaturation is achieved by heating saturated solution. For different processes such as boiling, fusion, etc., heat is also required. So these are the application of heat transfer, that is evaporation, distillation, drying and crystallization. Now coming to the objectives of heat transfer. To reduce the heat or energy loss and making energy utilization more effective. First is insulation. It is to reduce the heat transfer as much as possible across the system and its surrounding. Then second, enhancement. It is the promotion of heat transfer across a finite temperature difference. Then third, temperature control. The temperature of a region is required to be maintained close to a specified value. So the main objective of heat transfer are to study different mode of heat transfer, to determine the rate of heating and cooling, to plan changes in new heat transfer equipment. Now moving towards mechanism of heat transfer. The heat can travel from one place to another in three ways, that is conduction, convection and radiation. The heat will always find a way to transfer from the higher system to the lower system. Heat transfer is a dynamic process. Let's discuss about conduction, convection and radiation. So the first mechanism of heat transfer is conduction. Conduction is the transfer of heat between two substances that are in physical contact without mixing. Conduction is a process in which heat flows in a body is achieved by the transfer of the momentum of individual atoms or molecules without mixing, or transfer of heat from one atom to another within an object by in direct contact with each other. For example, flow of heat through metal shell of a boiler take place by conduction as far as solid wall or shell is considered. The flow of heat depends on the transfer of vibrational energy from one molecule to another, and in case of metal, the movement of free electrons. The better the conductor, the safer is the heat will be transferred, because metal is the good conductor of heat. Conduction occurs when a substance is heated. The particles acquire more energy and vibrate more. This molecule then bump in a neighboring particles and transfer same of their energy to them. It then continue and transmit the energy from the hot and the most of the cooler end of the substance. Then second mechanism, that is convection. In convection, thermal energy is transferred from hot place to cold place by mixing of warmer portion with cooler portion of same material. For example, water boiling in a pan. Another good example of convection is in the atmosphere. So basically, convection is a process in which heat flow is achieved by actual mixing of warmer portion with cooler portion of same material. It is the heat transfer due to bulk movement within fluid, such as gases and liquids. For example, heating of water by hot surface is mainly by convection. Now there are two types of convection: natural convection, which refers to a case where the fluid movement is created by the warm fluid itself. The density of fluid decreases as it is heated, thus hot fluid are lighter than cool fluid. Then second type is forced convection. Forced convection uses external means of producing fluid movement. Forced convection is what in winter days heat loss from your body is increased due to constant replenishment of cold air by the wind. Natural wind and fans are two most common sources of forced convection. Now coming to last mechanism, that is radiation. Radiation is a method of heat transfer that does not related to any contact between the heat source and the heated object, as in the case of conduction and convection. The heat can be transmitted at the empty space by electromagnetic radiation. The process of energy transfer is known as radiation. Example of radiation are the heat of sun or the heat generated by the filament of a bulb. So these are the three mechanisms of heat transfer. So in this session we complete basic definition of heat transfer, then objective of heat transfer, application and heat transfer mechanism. In next lecture we'll see how heat is transferring by conduction, convection and